Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, my dear students, here is your mathematics teacher Muhammad Al-Jassay from Pakistan International School, Taif, Saudi Arabia. Today we will continue our lecture number 78, chapter number 7. I am going to start our chapter number 7. Before we start our chapter number 7, we have n factorial. This can be written as in this way also. N factorial are n and 1, there is a dot below it. This is the sign of factorial. You can check it from your calculator also. N factorial is equal to n into n minus 1, n minus 2, up to so on, 3, 2, 1. For example, we have 4 factorial, it will be 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 0 factorial is equal to 1. After that we have NPR. This is permutation. NPR, permutation. Its formula, manually you can open up the formula. That is N factorial over N minus R factorial. With the help of calculator, we have the keys of NPR and NCR. What about NCR? This is combination, that is N factorial over R factorial into N minus R factorial. So these are the formulas will be applied here frequently in your chapter number 7 of your exercises 7.1 to 7.4 approximately. According to your reduced syllabus exercise 7.1, we are given question number 1, part number 5. Question number 1, part 5. That is 11 factorial over 4 factorial into 7 factorial. Dear students, you can write down 11 into 10, 9, 8, 7 factorial over 4 factorial into 7 factorial. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7 factorial is cancelled with that. So we stop here so that they can be cancelled out. So 11, 10, 9 and 8 divided by 4 factorial is 3, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Here is 4, 2 is the 8, it is cancelled out. 3, 3 is the 9. 11 into 10 into 3. So your answer is 330. That's your answer. I hope that you understood this part. After that we have part number 7, 9 and 10. And I am taking part number 10 because 7 and 9 they are similar. Here we will have part number 10, 15 factorial over 15 factorial into 15 minus 15 factorial. Dear students, you can have 15 factorial over 15 factorial into 0 factorial. 15 factorial they are cancelled out and 0 factorial is 1, so 1 over 1 is equal to 1. So in this way, that was your part number 10. After that we have our exercise 7.2. In 7.2 we have permutation. We are given, according to your reduced syllabus, we are given question number 1, 2, 3 and 5, 7, 8 like that. Here is so we have exercise 7.2, that is evaluate the following. 7.2, evaluate the following. Evaluate the following. We have 20 P3. 3. Your first part is 20B3. 20B3. According to permutation, that formula, you will have 20 factorial over 20 minus 3 factorial. 20 factorial can be written as 20 factorial can be written as 20 into 19 into 18, then 17 factorial over 17 factorial. 20 minus 3 is 17 factorial. So we started from 20, 19, 18, and then 17 factorial. We stop here so that they can be cancelled out. So we are having 20, 19, and 18. Our answer is 6840. Dear students, similarly, we can have other parts. For example, part number 4, 10B7. Part number 4, 10B7. 10 factorial over 10 minus 7 factorial. 10 factorial over 10 minus 7 factorial. 10 factorial over 3 factorial. We have 10 into 9 into 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3 factorial over 3 factorial. They are cancelled out. After that, you can multiply 10 into 9 into 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4. You can multiply with your calculator and get your answer. So it will be, for example, we are having 20 into 42, 20 multiplied by 42, 5 for the 20, then 42 multiplied by 72, then multiplied by 10, that will be 604800. 604800. Dear students, this is your answer. I hope that you understood this question. Here we have question number 2. We are given question number 2, find the value of n. We are given 3 parts here. NP2 is equal to 30, then 11PN is equal to 11, 10 into 9. So we can choose 2 parts from here. So question number 2, part 1. Question number 2, part 1. We have to find the value of n so that NP2 is equal to 30. NP2 is equal to 30. You can say this is n factorial over n minus 2 factorial is equal to 30. N factorial over n minus 2 factorial, this is the formula. Now you can write down n factorial as n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 factorial divided by n minus 2 factorial is equal to 30. They are cancelled out. N square minus n minus 30 is equal to 0. Make the pairs. N square minus 6n plus 5n minus 30 is equal to 0. N common n minus 6 plus 5 common n minus 6 is equal to 0. So we have n minus 6 into n plus 5 is equal to 0. N minus 6 is equal to 0, n plus 5 is equal to 0, n is equal to 6, and n is equal to minus 5. Definitely, number of terms will never be negative, so it is not possible. So your answer of n is 6. This is your answer. After that, we have part number 2. And then we have part number 3 also. So I am taking part number 3. Here is part number 3. Part number three is NP4 ratio N minus 1P3. Is equal to 9:1. 9:1. You know, ratio means division. NP4 over N minus 1P3, that is 9:1. What about NP4? N factorial over N minus 4 factorial. Whole divided by N minus 1 factorial over N minus 1 minus 3 factorial, that will be 9. Here is N factorial over N minus 4 factorial, take reciprocal of the denominator, so this will be N minus 1 minus 3, that will be N minus 4 factorial over N minus 1 factorial, that is equal to 9. N minus 4 factorial, N minus 4 factorial, they are cancelled out. And we have this N factorial over N minus 1 factorial. You can write down N into N minus 1 factorial over N minus 1 factorial is equal to 9. That is cancelled out. So we are left with N is equal to 9. N is equal to 9. After that, we have question number 3, and there are two parts. I am choosing part number 2. Actually, this is the proof. This is the proof of left hand side is equal to right hand side. These questions are important in the sense that we have already left hand side and right hand side. Here we have next question, part number 2. Yes, part number 2. This is NPR is equal to N minus 1 PR. Question number 3. Part 2. NPR is equal to N minus 1 PR. N minus 1 PR plus R into P N minus 1 PR minus 1. P N minus 1's P N minus 1 PR minus 1, and this is multiplied by R. You will take right hand side. Remember that left hand side is this one. This is the formula. simplification, we will get this answer. N factorial over N minus R factorial. So taking right hand side, N minus 1 P R, R into N minus 1 P R minus 1. Apply the formula, N minus 1 factorial over N minus R minus 1 factorial plus R into N minus 1 factorial over N minus 1 minus R plus 1 factorial. This minus this. Minus R plus 1. Sign is changed. Here we have N minus 1 factorial over N minus R minus 1 factorial plus R N minus 1 factorial over N minus R factorial. Dear students, we can take N minus 1 factorial common. Here we have 1 over N minus R minus 1 factorial plus R over N minus R into N minus R minus 1 factorial. Yes, we have N minus R into N minus R minus 1 factorial. Here you can take N minus R minus 1 factorial also common. N minus 1 factorial over N minus R minus 1 factorial. Inside we will have 1 plus R over N minus R. 1 plus R over N minus R. Now taking LCM, as N minus R, taking LCM as N minus R, this is multiplied by 1, N minus R plus R. R, R cancelled out. We have N into N minus 1 factorial. N into N minus 1 factorial. And in denominator we have N minus R into N minus R minus 1 factorial. Dear students, I told you already that in case of 3 factorial into 4, through 3 factorial into 4, then factorial will be shifted to the higher values, bigger number. That will be 4 factorial. Because 4 factorial is equal to 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So 3 factorial is 3 to 1. 4 is multiplied, it becomes 4 factorial. So that's why we can apply this factorial to bigger number, that is n factorial. Similarly, this factorial is shifted to n minus r, that is the bigger one than factorial. You can check right hand side of this formula, that will be n p r, which is equal to left hand side. We started from right hand side and got the answer in left hand side. So dear students, that was your question number 3. After that, we are given question number 5. Question number 5. Yes. What is the question number 5? How many signals can be given by 6 flags of different colors when any number of flags can be used at a time. There are total number of flags 6. Total number of flags 6. So the question was, how many signals can be given by 6 flags of different colors when any number of flags can be used at a time? It means no compulsion. So number of signals using one flag, number of signals using one flag is equal to 6P1. You can check it is 6 factorial over 6 minus 1 factorial, 6 factorial over 5 factorial, 6 into 5 factorial, 5 factorial cancelled out. We have 6 signal with 1 flag. Similarly, number of signals using 2 flags, 6P2. This will be 6P2. Yes, we can have 6 factorial over 6 minus 2 factorial. So, 6 factorial over 4 factorial. 6 into 5 into 4 factorial over 4 factorial. They are cancelled out. This will be 30. Number of signals using 2 flags at time, 6P2, we will have 30. Similarly, number of signals using 3 flags, 6P3. 6 factorial over 3 factorial. Actually, 6 minus 3 is 3 factorial. 6, 5, 4, 3 factorial over 3 factorial. That will be 120. 5 4 the 20 into 6, that is 120. After that, 4 flags, 6P4, 6 factorial over 2 factorial, 6 5 4 3 2 factorial over 2 factorial. Cancelled out, it will be 12 5 the, yes, 60 into 6, 360. After that, number of signals using 5 flags, 6P5, 6 factorial over 1 factorial, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, that will be equal to 720. So, dear students, after that, number of signals using 6 flags, 6P6, that will be 6 factorial over 0 factorial. You know, 6 factorial to 0 factorial is 1. So 6 factorial is again 720. Total number of signals. Therefore, total number of signals, that will be equal to 6 plus 30 plus 120 plus 360 plus 720 plus 720, the total is 1956. 1956. Dear students, that was your question number 5. After that, we are given question number 7. How many three-digit number can be found by using each of the digit 2, 3, 5, 7, 9 ones? So you can take this is question number 7.
Question number 7 is,
listen carefully. How many three digits number can be formed by using each one of the digit 2, 3, 5, 7, 6 ones only? So what is the total number of digits?
Total
number of digits.
Total number of digits are 5.
How many digits are using at a time?
Used at a time, 3 digit. Therefore 5p3,
that will be
5 factorial over 2 factorial, 5, 4, 3, 2 factorial over 2 factorial cancelled out. So this will be 60. Dear students, 4, 3, 12, 5, the 60, that is your answer.
After that, we have question number 8, 9, 10 and 11. So I am choosing question number 9 and 11. What is question number 9? Find the number of 5 digits. Question number 9. Find the number of 5 digits number that can be formed from the digits 1, 2, 4, 6, 8 when no digit is repeated. When no digit is repeated but number 1, the digit 2 and 8 are next to each other. Yes. 2 and 8 are next to each other. So that is the possibility. Here is
question number 9. Try to complete other parts. If you could not, contact me, inshallah, to do it. But you must try at home. I am leaving some parts for you as your homework. So I am taking
question number 9.
Part 1.
When 2 and 8 are next to each other.
When 2 and 8 are next to each other. Possibility of 2, 8 is equal to possibility of 2, 8 is equal to, we have how many numbers are there? 5 digit numbers. So 2 and 8 are combined. So that's why it is considered as a single unit. So it will be out of 5, it is considered single unit. It will be 4p4. Because out of 5, this 2 and 8 is compulsory. And it can be taken as a single unit. So it will be 4p4. That is 4 factorial is equal to 24. Then possibility of 8 2. Remember that there are 2 possibilities. They are next to each other, 2 and 8. 2 and 8 and 8 and 2. Same possibility. 4 factorial, that is 24. So what will be?
integer number,
therefore required 5-digit numbers is equal to 24 plus 24, that is 48.
48.
Remember that total number of digits using at a time. So total number of digits using at a time, it means that there is no preference. Here was the preference 2 and 8, 8 and 2, they were next to each other. But the total number of digits using at a time, that was total was 5p5. So here will be 5 factorial, that is 120. So dear students, the number of digits in which 2 and 8 are not next to each other, that is the question. Digits 2 and 8 are next to each other. So that was this answer. And part number 2 is, part number 2 same question. Total number of digits, digits 2 and 8 are not next to each other. Digit 2 and 8 are not next to each other. It means that out of total possibilities, that was 120, subtracting 48, that was for next to each other. From the total possibilities, we subtract the possibility of 2 and 8, 8 and 2 next to each other. So the remaining will be the digits which are not next to each other, that is 72. So dear students, that was your question number 9. After that, here we can have question number 11, 12, 13 and 14. So I think we can take, what is question number 11? How many 5-digit, a multiple of 5 can be formed from the digits 2, 3, 5, 7, 9 when no digit is repeated? So 5-digit multiples of 5. How many 5-digit multiples of 5 can be formed from when no digit is repeated? It means that, so 5 must be in the unit place, because this is the multiple of 5. 5 1 the 5, then 5 2 is the 10. So multiple of 5 will be the multiplication of the number with 5. So 5 is fixed in fact. So number which are multiple of 5, number which are multiples of 5, then 5 will be in unit place. If 5 is fixed, then how many possibilities left? Definitely, we will have the possibility of 4. There are 5 digits. 1 is fixed. There is no permutation. There is no change. There is no variation of that value. So the remaining numbers will be have permutation. So this is 4p4. No number was repeated. So that's why 4p4. This is 4 factorial. 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, that will be 24. That is your answer. Dear students, this was your question number 11. After that, we have question number 12 And question number 13, they are similar. Question number 13, find the number of arrangement of 3 books on English and 5 books on Urdu. For placing them on shelf such that the books on the same subject are together.
Okay.
So what is the question? Actually, you have to understand that. There are total 8 books in which 3 are English books and 5 are Urdu books. So you have to place them in such a way that same subject books will be on the same side. So arrangement of 8 books. Question number 13. Arrangement of 8 books will be of the form 3 factorial into 5 factorial. 3 books English, 5 books Urdu. These are the possible placement of these books. 3 factorial to 5 factorial, it will be 720. And the second possibility is 5 factorial into 3 factorial, that will be 720. There is a possibility that on left hand side English books, on right Urdu. Possibility left, Urdu books are on left hand side, English on the right hand side. So you can have total possibilities, that will be 720 plus 720, that is 1440. So dear students, that was your question number 30. After that, question number 40. In how many ways can 5 boys and 4 girls be seated on the bench so that girls and boys occupy alternate seats? So there are 5 boys, 4 girls. Then we have to give them the place to sit down on alternate places on the bench. So alternate arrangement of 5 boys and 4 girls. This is your question number 14. Question number 14. Yes, we have alternate arrangements. Alternate arrangements of 5 boys and 4 girls are, yes, we have alternate arrangement of 5 boys and 4 girls are boy 1, girl 1, boy 1, girl 1, boy 2, girl 2, boy 3, girl 3, boy 4, girl 4, then at the end, boy 5. There are 5 boys sitting on alternate seats. And these are the girls which are also sitting on alternate seats, and these are the 4 girls. So you can check, it will be how many boys are total. Out of 5 boys, we have boy 1. So this is 5P1. And out of girls, there were 4 girls. That will be 4P1. Then we have fifth boy. Here is the fourth boy. 4P1. Then girl was second. That will be from 4. Or rather, it will be third. 3P1. Because This was fifth boy, this is fourth boy. This was fourth girl, this is third girl. Then that will be fifth and fourth sat down. Then we have 3P1 and girl was 2P1. Then 5, 4, 3. Then what will be? Fifth boy, fourth boy, third boy, second boy, and girl is the last one girl. That will be fourth girl, third girl, second girl, and then 1P1. And here is again 1P1. That was the last boy. This is the place for that. Here you can check. 5P1 is actually 5. 4P1 is 4. 4P1 is 4. 3P1 is 3. Then 3, then 2, then 2, then 1 into 1. So you multiply all. You multiply all. That will be 16, 5, 80. 80 into 9, 720, then 720 into 4, that will be 2880. Dear students, that was your exercise 7.2. After that, we have exercise 7.3. In case of 7.3, we are given question number 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, and 11. Now, question number 3. How many arrangements of the letters of the word attacked can be made if each arrangement begins with C and ends with K? So you have to find, you have to make the letters in which C and K are fixed. C will be at first place, K will be at last place. Here we have question number 3, exercise 7.3, question number 3. In question number 3, the word is attacked. So here we have attack S, C and K are fixed because C will be at the first place and K will be at the last place. Therefore, we get the form, here is C, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. C, and here is this is 7, and this one is K. So, dear students, as C and K are fixed, so we will get the form of the letters like that. All the numbers which are present in between C and K, they are movable, they are variable. But C and K are fixed. So here we can see how many times leaving this C and K, how many times A is coming? A, two times. Then T, two times. Then E, once. And D, once. So what is the total possibility? Basically, total number of words in which C and K occupy first and last position. Therefore, total numbers of words in which C and K are fixed are, what are the total possibilities? Here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. This is 6 factorial over A is coming 2 times, 2 factorial. T is coming 2 times, 2 factorial. E is once and D is once. So we can have 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 divided by 2 into 1, then 2 into 1, then 1 into 1. So 2, 2 cancelled out, this 2 will cancel 4. We are left with 6, 5, 30 and this is 6. So what will be? Six, five, four, three, two, one. This is 180. So this is your answer. 180 is your answer. These are the number of terms they are coming. After that, we have question number 5. How many 6-digit number can be formed from the digits 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4? How many then will be in line between that? So basically, total number of arrangement is how many total are? This is the 6. Possibility is 6. 2 is coming 2 times, 3 is coming 2 times, 4 is coming 2 times. So in this way, you can find your answer. After that, question number 6. 11 member club form 4 committees of 3, 4, 2, 2 members so that no member is the member of more than one committee. Find the number of committees. Basically, 11 members of club form 4 committees. Yes? And they are members so that the number is the member more than one committee. So no member will be more than one committee. So we will have this is question number 6. Yes, 3, 4, 2, 2. There are total required arrangements, total arrangements. Question number, this is question number 6. Arrangement required. Remember that there are total 11 members and no member is repeated in 4 members committee. So we are given 3 members, 3 factorial. One time they are coming. They are coming one time. 3 factorial, 4 factorial.
2 factorial and 2 factorial.
After simplifying, you can use your calculator. Even you have the key in your calculator, NPR. So you can choose. This is NPR. Here is 11. Factor 11 into 10 into 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, and then 4 factorial. So you, after cancellation, we will get this answer 69300. Dear students, that was your question number 6. After this, we have question number 7. The DCOs of 11 districts meet to discuss the law and order of the situation in their districts. In how many ways can they be seated at the round table when two particular DCOs insist on sitting together? There were total 11 DCOs. Out of 11 DCOs, 2 DCOs insist to sit together. So if 2 are insisting sit together, they are fixed. So what will be total number of ways? Here we can have total number of ways. Total number of ways of sitting around a round table, that is, two are insisting sitting together, so 2 factorial into total were 11, so other were 9 factorial. 2 factorial into 9 factorial, so after that we can have this 2 factorial being 2 into 1, then 9 factorial is 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. They are multiplied to get